Dear brothers and sisters, today I want to say a few words about what's happening today in the Orthodox Church, in the Russian Orthodox Church. And it will be not about faith or spiritual life per se, but about the actual events that are taking place. And I will share with you my just my own view on what's happening. It is not the truth, and my knowledge is limited. The information I have is limited, and however, I feel that it is important because this is the Orthodox Church this day in 2021, not 2,000 years ago. This was happening right now, here and now, and it is also important because through all the things that happen, we gain experience. We see that the Old Testament is all life of old Israel, of old Testament church, and now we are the new Israel, not me, but the Orthodox Church, and in the New Testament, the life of the apostles, it's about the church, what happened. Okay, so what happens now is also important, in my view. And this situation has both negative things and positive things, but it shows that the church is alive, okay? It is alive, it's not dead, okay? And I want also to stress that I have love towards everyone who is involved in this situation, okay? It's not some gossiping that I just want to criticize somebody, no. I want to say that I am praying, and I can understand the logic behind what everybody does or says, and I really hope that the Lord gives wisdom to everyone. The situation is with the monastery that was, had the former priest, Sergey Romanov. Last year he spoke against Putin, he spoke against Patriarch, he had these conspirological position, which may be true. I don't say it's false, okay, that there are powers they control. It may be partly true, okay, not completely true. We will see that it's not true completely from what happened. Okay, he said that these evil powers control Russia, and now just give to me, Father Sergey, they give to me all the power, and I will fix everything in Russia in 3 days. Okay, and other statements, okay, that he will curse everybody who is closing the churches because of coronavirus and many other things. Okay. And I spoke with him last year over the phone when all this was happening in the summer last year. So I have a little bit of understanding of what is happening and what is behind all of this. Okay, my understanding is limited, as I said. Okay, from what I see, from what I know, just recently, okay, we know that Father Sergey last December, he was taken and he is put in prison, and he's still in prison. Okay, just recently he had a message recorded from the prison. It's like a sermon, about 7 minutes. You can find it in the internet. And in this sermon, he is calling that people don't stir up the situation, that they remain peaceful, that they pray to God, that all reliance is upon God, and pray for the president, pray for the government. Okay, we can see that his position has changed, okay, in this sermon. The reason, okay, so today I want to discuss his position. I want to discuss the government, okay, what's happening with the government in Russia. I want to discuss the church. There is a channel that had a talk show about this topic, and it's like one of the official big channels. also the some of the elite in Russia, the reaction to what is happening. Okay, some people who are reacting to this. Okay, because there was also a message by Maria Shukshina. She's an actress, daughter of a big director, movie director, okay, so what is what we can see from this speech of Father Sergey, former Father Sergey, now he is Nicholas Romanov, because he was defrauded from priesthood and excommunicated by the church. What we can see, first of all, we need to have compassion towards him. He is in prison, and the reason why they put him in prison, it's obvious that it's fake. Okay, because they say he was calling people to commit suicide, and he was just saying that he, are you ready to die for your country? Are you ready to die for Christ? He was asking someone this question, this was recorded, and they said, okay, this shows that he is convincing immature person, underage, to commit suicide. Okay, this is nonsense. Okay, so we can understand that it's a fake accusation. They just wanted to put him somewhere so that he is silent, that he doesn't say anything. Okay, so he is now in that prison, and his position, what he says, can tell us two things. First thing, of course, we can see that, okay, he is broken in some way. But what he says is what he believes now, okay? And it's not fake, okay? What he says is not fake. This means two things. It means that from communicating with those officials, okay, and those people who put him into prison, I'm sure they had a lot of communication there. He found out that it's not as bad as he was saying. Okay, that it's Antichrist controlling everything, and it's not that bad. The government is trying to sustain the situation as it is. Okay, and this situation includes support to the church that is given by the government. Even though there are different many problems in Russia and in the way Russia is run, but the government is supportive to the church generally. Okay, it's not persecutions like in Soviet times. Okay, and it's not indifferent completely. Just okay, so that's a different topic. There's a different story. Who is using whom? It's both using each other. Okay, the government is using the church, you're using the government. So it's a complicated situation. But overall, it's not that bad for the church, the situation that the government, the position that's taken right now. Okay, so he was explained these things, and it's obvious that he understood that it's not as bad as he thought. That's why now he's he's saying this direct support to the government. It should be, people should pray for the government, they should not get involved too much and rely on Christ. Okay, that's the main message. And another thing that we can see about the government from this situation is that there are people in the government that if they want to fix someone, okay, they don't like you, okay, because you say some things that are really too much, okay, they can fix you, okay, they can use whatever means to fix you, okay, including such, fake accusations. So it's not the whole government is like that, but there are people there who can do that. Okay, they have means and power, influence to do that. Okay, so this is, but it's on individual level. It's not systematic. It's not like totalitarian control and pressure and censor. So this is the situation, okay, with the Romanov and the government. And then we have the this talk show on the channel, Russian channel, church channel. And the channel has two goals also. One goal is to make people peaceful. There is no split, there is no quarrel. So they try to also have black and white. Okay, the church position is right, is good, everything is fine. But this Romanov, he is the bad guy. Okay, he created the split, he creates that and this. Okay, so it also has to have this black and white. And the second goal that they have is to show that the church is right. Okay, the official church decisions about Romanov, it's all fine. Okay, so they have these two. It is a systematical. Okay, they have to have that. And the outcome is not nice. Okay, the outcome that we can see in this talk show, first of all, they have no compassion towards this guy, okay, which worked for the church for many years, for decades, and was accused unjustly. Regardless of his strange views and his sectarian mindset and other things, regardless of that, you need to have some compassion. You're the church. You need to worry, you need to pray for everything, especially if he is accused wrongly. Okay? And there is nothing said that this was wrong or there is a question about it. Okay? Because no criticism about the government. Okay? So this is another unpleasant thing that we can see. So you either don't talk about it, okay, if you cannot say like the whole truth, okay, or you don't try to make it that kind of show that people can see a lot of hypocrisy in it. Okay, so this is the situation. The position we can understand, and it's reasonable. And we can agree that, okay, they are supposed to say the things that they say, but this is not the truth, and people, they want to hear the truth from the church and not just everything is fine, everything is good and stuff like that. Okay, so this is the situation with this channel. And another thing that they discuss there is this speech by Maria Shukshina when she received some medal from government, from I think it's Prime Minister who gave her this medal, and she had this speech to thank him and everyone for this. In this speech, she criticized heavily the situation in Russia. The culture is dead, is killed, and the government is not doing anything about it, and nobody cares, and there are no heroes as we used to have, but there are actually very few heroes, but it's you cannot talk about them, okay? Because everybody will say that you're crazy or that you're bad. So she is referring to Romanov, we can understand, because she herself was very supportive of Romanov when all that happened last year. So she did not say out loud, but everybody understood that's what she's talking about. So now what is this, what does this tell us? Okay, this tells us that the church has priests. Okay, just regular priests and regular bishops, and you know, it's like army, and everybody is working to kill the enemy in front of them. Okay, daily basis, every priest is working hard to fight with the devil on this level, on the individual people level. Okay, and overall, this of course is a great positive influence on the society, on the people of God. But to have this running, the priests, they don't go to these high portals, okay, and come out on the TV talk shows and criticize publicly some things that are happening up there, okay, okay, this big evil that there is, okay, in terms of how the government runs the things, how the church is managing things and stuff like that. They are not empowered and they don't dare to go there, okay? Because if they do, everything what they do on daily basis is going to be ruined, okay? So they don't do that. We can understand that. It's not because they are cowards. It's not because they are thoughtless. They don't care. They don't understand. Many of them, they understand, okay? But it's not their task, okay? They're not in the position to do that. Okay, and there is nothing wrong with this. So there is a lack of church voice on that level, that high level, against some evils that there are in the society, in the world, and everywhere. Okay, so that's why many people, especially elite like the Maria Shukshina, they don't hear this voice on that level from the church. Okay, and they are looking for people who do care, and they find them, like she found Romanov, okay, and that's why she was supportive, like a patriotic, and really dare to speak about how he sees the truth, okay, and she did not support him for his sectarian ideas, okay, she did not support him for his exorcism that he was doing, okay, which is questionable. She was supporting him, as I understand, because of his freedom from the system and ability to say things that nobody else says, okay, openly, publicly, loudly. So that's why she supported him. And and of course, people like her, very few. And she is a lay person. She doesn't have theological education, so she might be clumsy in the way she does it, in the way she speaks about things related to church, to God, but she is she has this pain, she that she can see that some unjust things happening, and she wants to bring it up. She wants to fight evil on that level. Okay, so we need to understand this, and we need to be supportive of people like that. Okay, maybe help them, guide them to avoid big errors, mistakes. But this church channel, of course, if Romanov is bad guy, everybody who supports him is also stupid, bad, or something wrong with them. Okay, so this is also quite ugly. Okay, this kind of position. So we need to understand what's happening. The church is alive and is fighting with devil. And it's quite complicated, the whole situation, okay? And the devil is trying to use this complexity to make people quarrel with each other or do wrong things. But we need to be wise, we need to have love towards everyone, to try to understand why everyone is doing what he is doing or saying, and to see that that people are good. No need to see evil everywhere, okay? So let us pray for the whole situation. Let us pray that the Lord may strengthen our faith. Very often it's because lack of faith, lack of trust in God, that problems happen. And that He gives us wisdom and victory over all enemies, visible and invisible. I mean, God bless.